We got Chicago, Nashville, Central Division battle, 13-14. Nashville minus 170 home chalk. The total, 5.5s and 6s, a little bit of both. We've got 5.5 minus 120 to minus 125 at some spots, 6 shaded to the under in others. So make sure you're using SBROdds.com, getting the number you want with whatever total you're looking to bet here in this Hawks Predators game. You know, Chicago, it remains a grind for this hockey team, although they finally had a good game prior to the break. They beat Detroit. You know, it's a nice win, but it's Detroit as well. Let's see what you can do now on the road against Nashville here in this spot. Not going to be as easy for this Chicago team. Not a game I did a whole plan on doing a whole lot with from a betting perspective. So I'm going to let Alex as well as Dana take over here, talk about this game. They clearly have a stronger thought on it than I do. Let's go to Alex. Hawks in Nashville tonight. What are you looking at here?
Well, last episode I called out the Hawks, and they showed up with a big 5-1 win on the road. Like you said, it's against Detroit. We're talking about one of the weaker teams in the East. It's not going to do much of anything. But now Hawks coming back. Everybody's rested. Patrick Kane was the only guy who played in the All-Star game, and he didn't really do much of anything in for the Central. So, you know, now if they want to try and make a run, you know, this is obviously you have to start off with beating a good team and a good division team here in Nashville. Nashville's getting back Philip Forsberg most likely. If not tonight, he'll be back within the week. So a team that was missing a lot, you know, one of their obviously their best offensive player. They've been playing well even though without him, they've won, you know, 5 of their last 6 games. So this is going to be a tough game. I think we've seen these two teams play really tough even when the Hawks have struggled. Seen 5 of the last 7 meetings decided by 1 goal. So the Hawks know that this is a, you know, this is basically one of their biggest rivals, and it's a good team, a team that they're going to have to try to eclipse if they're going to make any kind of run here. Same thing with Nashville. They know it's a team that they can never take lightly in the Hawks because they always tend to show up for them. I mentioned in the chat about how this time of year from now all the way through into the playoffs, I kind of look at team totals, also kind of look at regulation bets. I think there might be some value here in possibly seeing this game go into overtime. You can find a 3-1 price here. You know, this game being tied after overtime, so look for 3-way or regulation spots. That's something I might be looking at here. Maybe put a half unit on, you know, a shot to 3-1. I think the Hawks can play tight defensively. They know they have to tighten things up defensively, especially with Anton Forsberg in net, who's played fairly well except for the one bad spot he had, that 7-3 loss against the New York Islanders. So if they can tighten up things defensively, play rested, play fast, and try and match intensity with Nashville tonight, I think we could see this be a really close game. So I won't be betting anything side or total-wise, but I might be looking at possibly with that three-way play.
All right, looking for a tight game between the Hawks and Predators tonight. And Dana Lane also with talking Chicago-Nashville here on this card. What are you looking at here, Dana, in Music City as the Predators look to keep on rolling to begin the second half?
Yeah, I completely agree with you, Alex. I mean, I think Chicago's going to – I think they'll come out with a fantastic effort tonight, and they have to because, you know, honestly, if they miss the playoffs, I mean, this is going to be the first time in, what, 10 years that they haven't made the playoffs. And, of course, if the season ended today, they'd be out right now. So, yeah, defensively, I think that they're going to show up. And, of course, we know that the Nashville Predators always show up. They always buy into Peter Laviolette's system. And even though that the Predators have not had the luxury of actually putting their full team on the ice this year, they stay afloat just because they play well defensively. So this total for me is a little bit high. And you guys know I like the bet under, so I kind of look for an under to play, and this one to me kind of stands out because I think Chicago is, in order to stay in this game, I don't think this is going to be a 4-3, 5-4 game. I think this is going to be more of a 3-2 game, and that's where Chicago needs to have it in an effort to you know, come out on top on this. And the other thing too is Pekka Rinne, guys. I know I've ripped on him, and you know, this is a guy that's, you know, one day he's fantastic, the next day he's not. But fortunately for him, he is on one of those rolls again, and I think I can trust him. I feel good about where Forsberg is. I think at least if he gives a nominal effort, or at least if he gives an average effort, I think that we have a shot at cashing his ticket. I think it's going to be close. And I wouldn't be surprised. I don't like when I don't get the halves attached to my total, but I'll take a chance on the under tonight.
All right, under for Dana Lane here in this particular hockey game.
Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to our channel. Now we've put a lot of work into producing all these free videos, so please help us out and keep all our content free for you forever by simply liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing. Now, not to mention, a visit to our industry-leading website will warm the hearts of all our SBR employees, especially myself. Now, the links are over there to the left, so do check those out. Thanks for watching.